The House voted today to form a bipartisan commission to probe the January 6th Capitol insurrection. 35 Republicans crossed party lines to vote with Democrats. The bill still needs to pass the Senate, where Democrats will need to flip at least 10 Republicans for it to pass. We have crews going in-depth on each of these stories for you tonight. Let's begin with Joe Khalil. He is live in Washington, D.C., with more on the vote in response to that independent commission from January 6th. Joe.
Yeah, Marty, it played out as we expected it to. Every Democrat supported it. About three dozen or so Republicans supported it, so it's a lot of support there. But this bill's future is going to fare with Senate Republicans once the bill goes over to the other chamber. Are there enough there to make this bill law? And a lot of senators we talked to today on the Republican side are still on the fence, but party leaders have come out in opposition to it. And we know that their word carries a lot of sway.
The bill is passed.
35 Republicans broke ranks and joined Democrats to pass the bill, creating a January 6th commission. Congressman Tim Ryan delivering this passionate support for the bill shortly before the vote.
We have people scaling the Capitol, hitting the Capitol police with lead pipes across the head, and we can't get bipartisanship.
Despite its passage, the commission's future is now uncertain. Republican leaders have come out against it. Late Tuesday, former President Trump released a statement urging Republican leaders to vote against what he calls a Democrat trap. And Wednesday, the Senate's top Republican also came out against it.
I've made the decision to oppose the House Democrats' slanted and unbalanced proposal.
But Republicans who worked on the January 6th Commission proposal say that's not the case.
Put down their swords for once, just for once, and support this bill.
Their proposal creates a 10-member body, 5 appointed by Democrats, 5 by Republicans. No members of Congress would sit on it, and both sides have equal subpoena power.
Senate will come to order.
The commission's fate now lies in the hands of Senate Republicans, and many say they're skeptical.
But who chooses the staff, who chooses who they interview, and all who chooses who to subpoena? I think those are deeper questions that could skew this.
Just today, the FBI released more video of the mob's assault on Capitol Police. Some Republicans have downplayed the attack, including Congressman Andrew Clyde, who recently said images from January 6th looked like a normal tourist visit. These images show Congressman Clyde barricading himself on the wall of the chamber, rioters minutes away from breaking in. And the House is going to vote tomorrow on a supplemental bill. This is a $1.9 billion security upgrade to the Capitol. That is a direct response to January 6th. That bill has the support, along with the one that passed today, of Officer Howard Liebengood's family. He's an officer who committed suicide just a day after January 6th. His family sending out a statement urging Congress to pass both of those bills. Rob.
All right, Joe, thank you very much.